Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's take a look at the new two-step verification process for your Apple ID. So two-step verification is a new security measure for your Apple ID. Now, Apple IDs are very important because you use them to log on to lots of things. For instance, you can use them to log on to iTunes. You can use them to log on to the App Store, the Mac App Store. Also, if you're a developer, your developer account. And there's all sorts of different services that Apple offers, including iCloud, that can use your Apple ID. So keeping it secure is very important. That means not letting anybody else guess your password or log in or somehow be able to change your user account in any way. Two-step verification aims to make it very secure. A lot of other companies are already using a similar process. For instance, Google implemented this with their whole ecosystem, Gmail and every other thing that's part of your Google account a while ago. So it's about time that Apple got on board and offered two-step verification for those that really want to secure their account. So previously, if you wanted to change your password with your Apple ID, you would log in to your Apple ID account at Apple site and then go to password and security, and you can simply click and change your password. So all you needed to do to change your password was actually your old password. So somebody who got a hold of your old password could change your account so you couldn't have access to it anymore. And even if they didn't have your old password, they could use these security questions here and try to get access to it by calling Apple. And it's easy sometimes to reverse engineer these answers to figure out what they might be. Matter of fact, a lot of people have gotten their accounts broken into, celebrities for one thing, by simply figuring out what the answers to their security questions would be. So two-step verification aims to make this more secure by getting rid of the idea of security questions and the idea that you can simply use your old password to change your new to a new password. So to start the two-step verification process, what you would need to do is click the Get Started button there at the top, and then you start the process there. And all the way through the process, Apple walks you through and explains what two-step verification is and how it's used. So here are the three basics. There's no security questions, like I said before. The whole purpose is to make it harder for anybody else to get access to your account to change your password. And if you do forget your password, you can still reset it, and I'll show you how. So this screen really sums it up. It tells you there are three pieces of information that you can use to get access to your account. You only need two of them. So one is your password. The other is a trusted device, like say for instance your iPhone, or it could be any phone with SMS capability. And the third is this recovery key that you're going to get. So it's kind of a long password that's going to randomly give to you and then you store somewhere. If you have two out of the three, you can get access to your account. So if you do forget your password, as long as you have the other two, you can get in and reset your password. And the third part you might have seen there is that Apple can't help you in resetting your password after you start with two-step verification. Now this makes things incredibly more secure because it means there's less points of failure. Somebody can call Apple and say the right things and get access to your account. They can't do it at all. Matter of fact, it's probably true that Apple doesn't even have the ability to do this. Your password is encrypted and everything is stored on the server in such a way that humans can't actually get to it. It has to be you with either that recovery key or your password and then those trusted devices to be able to get to your account. So not only will Apple not help you in recovering a lost password, but they probably can't, and that's what makes it secure. So the big part in setting this up is enabling one or more of your trusted devices. So this would, for instance, be your iPhone. Now the idea here is for somebody to get access to your account, they need either the password or that super password, that recovery key, and one of these trusted devices. So say you have your iPhone with you. You want to log into your account. So you go to log in, you type in your password. And what's going to happen is it's going to send a code, just a 4-digit code, to your phone. Then you see that code appear on the screen, and then you type it in to log into your account. So this way, the only way to get access to your account is to, number one, know the password. Number two, actually have one of those trusted devices with you to be able to see that code and then enter it in on your computer. Here you can see the verification process. So what's going to happen is you're going to choose one of the devices that you have set up in your iCloud account here, and then you're going to get a code, a verification code delivered to it, and then you enter it in here, and then that will make it verified. And you can see here I verified two devices. So I've verified my iPad and my iPhone. And if you don't have one of those devices, just anything with an SMS access will do. So for instance, another brand of phone will do just fine. The other thing you're going to get is your recovery key. Now this is kind of like your backup password. Remember, you need 2 out of 3 things to be able to change your account. You need your password, you need the code that's going to appear on your device, or this recovery key. So if you do, say, lose the device and need to get access to your account, or you forget your password, you can then still get access to the account by using the other 2. So this recovery key is important. You want to print it out and put it somewhere safe. You can also, of course, store it on your computer in some sort of safe thing, like I have an encrypted password keeper program, and I can put it in there, and it's just as safe there as it is printed out and put somewhere hidden in the house. So you just want to make sure you have this as your backup. It's very important. And it's part of any two-step verification process that you have this kind of backup recovery key. So now that you've set up two-step verification, you go back to this original password and security screen. You can see the security questions are gone. You have your trusted devices listed and you can manage them and add and remove them. You can replace your lost recovery key. So you can basically generate a new one because you've got access to the other 2. Anytime you have access to 2 out of 3, you can make changes to these. You can go in and just do your normal change of password there, password and the code that will come through on your security device, your iPhone or whatever. So you don't have to switch to this new process, at least not right now. You can stick to the old one. If you do, please make sure that your password is a nice strong one and make sure that your security questions are something people can't guess. I used to have the answers to my security questions be a group of random words. Like, what was your first car? And it was just a bunch of random words that I picked out by opening a book and pointing to words randomly. So nobody could actually guess it, and it would seem really weird if I ever had to answer the questions, but it would have been very secure. But switching to two-step verification makes it ultimately secure. And of course, someone like me who actually uses their Apple ID account for lots of different things, since I'm an Apple developer and I use the account for all sorts of other things as well, I of course switched to it immediately. For typical users, it may not be quite as important as long as you have a strong password and your security questions can't be guessed. So what's the downside? Well, the downside is, remember, Apple can't help you now recover a lost password. You've got to have 2 out of 3 things. You've got to have your device, your password, and your recovery key. You've got to have 2 out of those 3 in order to go and make changes. So if you think it might be difficult to actually make sure you keep all 3 available, then perhaps this level of security isn't for you. Should note a few things. First is that if you go to set up this process and you recently made a change, like you've changed some piece of information on your account, like a new password, then it's not going to allow you to set it up right away. It's going to give you a 3-day waiting period. Basically, this means if somebody else tried to get into your account, set it up with two-step verification, which means you'll never get access to it again, then you'll have some time to back out of it. In other words, you get an email saying, hey, somebody's trying to do this, and if it's not you, you can then stop the process. So that's why there's a 3-day delay for some people. There wasn't for me. I hadn't made a change in the last few weeks, so I was good to go. Another thing to notice is that not all countries have this available. Right now it's available in the USA and a few other places, but I'm sure that soon enough it will be rolled out to everywhere that has Apple IDs. Now Apple has a frequently asked questions page that you can visit here at this URL, and I have no doubt that over time they might add more questions to this as people ask more questions. But you can get a lot of answers to very specific questions here at this page. So check that out too. So it's important to realize this doesn't really change very much as far as your day-to-day use of your Apple ID. For instance, to just log into your iTunes account or buy apps in the App Store, it looks like you just use your password as normal. And Apple does say that you will need two-step verification to make purchases, so I'm assuming some purchases, at least in the future, may require the two-step process. But for now, it looks like it's basically there just to prevent somebody from getting access and making changes to your account, which is the most important thing. So I hope you found this look at two-step verification useful. Ask any questions here in the comments at this post at MacMost.com, and we can discuss two-step verification and whether or not it's a good idea for you. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it'll just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched and go to that page. Underneath the video, you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.